Hi, welcome to this video. Let's see all advanced tools inside SketchUp Pro 2015. Leave us feedback to improve our future videos. In our beginner tutorial, we have seen some basic features this software has. But if you want to go professional, you need to know some other important features that are hidden by default. If you go to View and then to Toolbars, you can open and close groups of tools from your workspace simply by checking next to each. We will see the most important toolbars listed here. Solid Tools contains some important operations you can do using two solids. To see how these new tools work, make sure to open also the Styles toolbar. This is useful to change the way to see your solids, with full opacity, with wireframes only, or with some transparency using X-ray. This is one of the best views in case you are going to use the solid tools. First of all, let's suppose to have two solids. The solid tools work fine if you use cubes or solid groups. So, if you have cylinders, cones, or anything that is not a simple cube, you must create groups, right-clicking on them and going to Make Group. In this way, SketchUp recognizes them as solids, and so you can use the solid tools on them. Let's suppose that these solids do overlap. If you enable Outer Shell and select the two solid groups, SketchUp creates a final solid that is the union of the two, removing all interior faces and contours not visible outside. Plus, external contours will be added. If you use Intersect and you select the two solids, you will obtain just the solid part that is overlapped. If you use Union and select the two solids, the final solid will be the union of these two. Subtract removes from the second solid defined the parts of the first solid that do overlap on the second one. Trim is just like a subtract, with the difference that the first solid is not removed. Split simply separates the overlapped part from the two solids, creating one on its own. These tools always work on two solids or solid groups. If you need to work with more than two solids, you must create a group that contains more solids, and then you can go on using the tool. Don't make groups that contain other groups, or tools may not work. Moreover, if you want to obtain contours without editing solids, you can simply right-click on the overlapped solid and go to Intersect Faces with Model. Contours are added as simple lines, as you can see with the Select tool. Layers are also important. When your project starts to be complex, you can define layers to hide what you don't need at the moment, and this can make your work much easier. In the Toolbars list, check Layers. Each object you draw belongs to just one layer, called Layer 0 by default. If you click on the Info icon, you will open the Layers window. This lists all existing layers in your project. You can create new layers clicking on the plus in the top left corner. The down arrow in the toolbar lets you choose the current layer to use. For example, if it is set at layer 1, all future objects drawn will belong to such layer. You can also change the layer which the object has to belong to by selecting the object and changing the layer using the toolbar. In this case, such toolbar is colored in yellow. It is important to associate layers to objects in order to hide them where you don't need them. In the Layers window, you can check and uncheck layers to make their objects visible or invisible. You can delete selected layers going on the minus in the top left corner. In case you want to draw personalized shapes, you can use the Sandboxes, also called the Mesh Objects. Open Sandbox in the Toolbars list. A sandbox is a mesh, such as a shape, divided in lots of smaller regular pieces, such as rectangles or triangles. From this base, you can build your own personalized shapes using the Lines tool and the Sandbox tools. To create a mesh base, you can start from scratch. Define the grid sides simply typing with your keyboard and using Enter key to apply. The smaller the grid is, the more precise you will be, but be careful, because smaller grids may load your computer too much. Then click on a point and stretch a line. Then fix a third point to set direction and area. This sandbox can be moved, scaled and rotated using the edit tools on top, as seen for normal objects. If you scale, the grids will be smaller as well. In this case, you can find the shape of your mesh. When you are ready, start drawing using the Lines tool and the mesh as base. Even more, you can use the Sandbox tools to create your personalized shape. Mind that the Sandbox tools work on objects that can be divided in multiple triangles, so you can use these on polygons, rectangles, or any filled closed path that lays on a single plane. If you want to edit mesh objects in detail, you must first explode them to extract all its triangles or rectangles. Just right-click on the sandbox and go to explode. Mind not to take sandboxes too large, or your computer may lag quite a lot. The smooth tool moves up or down a vertex, a side, or an entire face of a normal object, depending on your settings. First of all, define the active radius, typing the number and using Enter to apply. The number will appear next to radius below. Then simply drag from one of the yellow vertices or any side or face you see. The bigger is the radius, set as a red circle, the more object sides and or vertices will be deformed if you drag. All nodes and sides that do not fall inside the red circle won't be moved or deformed. So if you want to move an entire face, click on the face and drag. If you want to drag a side, select it and drag. All inside the red circle will be deformed. If you want to drag a vertex, drag from its yellow node. You can use the Smooth tool on the sandbox as well. Just explode it first and, without losing the selection, enable the Smooth tool. The Stamp tool is used to create faster mesh objects with complex shapes. First of all, you need to select a plane face or a solid group that lays above or below the part of the mesh you want to modify. Define then the offset by typing with your keyboard and confirm with Enter key. This offset is represented by a red shape distant as much as you defined. Then simply click on the interested mesh and drag up or down to give the correct height. You edit the sandbox in order to keep the face chosen. The inclination of the height is major for bigger offsets defined first. In case you have a solid group selected, its base will be taken as face. Drape is used to paste on your mesh a shadow contour created by an object that stays above. Use Add Detail on triangular sides to add more lines, whereas use Flip Edge to flip the sides direction. In this way, you can edit your sandbox better. Mind that the sandbox tools do also work on objects that are not related to mesh objects. For example, it is quite fast to create a pyramid using the Smooth tool on a polygon. You can also create a mesh from a defined contour. Select first the contour from which create the mesh and create from contours on top. The mesh object works fine as long as you use simple shapes, like rectangles or polygons. If you use circles or arcs, you may need to be more careful on the tools you use. When your complex shape is done, you may need to convert it to a normal object. Since the sandbox is simply a shape composed by lots of sides and vertices, you can simply use the Erase tool to remove all extra lines you don't need. Just hold your click on. Mind that this action can't be undone later. Erase all just when you have finished. You can also add fog and shadow. Just go to View and then to Fog or Shadow. If you enable the Shadows toolbar, you can also decide the hour and the month to set up shadow according to the sun position. Click on the first icon to adjust the shadow settings instead. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel for more amazing video tutorials.